Dear students, in this part of the lecture, we will discuss the syllabus on particular emphasis on the course description and the brief overview about the introduction, the course objectives, and learning outcomes. Dear students, as you know, that's the course title, Industrial Pharmacy 2. Required course code is PCU608, having credit hours 3, and this course is designed with aim to provide the students the knowledge of various dosage form and equipment used for their formulation. And different dosage form we will discuss in this course about emulsion, one of the biphasic dosage form of the two immiscible liquids, which is stabilized by addition of emulsifying agents, suspension in case of the insoluble drugs, semi-solid dosage form which includes ointments, paste, which are used for the external application to the skin and mucous membrane. Apart from these dosage form, we will also focus on the steroid products, that is free from pyrogens and routine. We say that steroid products are some of the injectable products available in the market. You can see these are steroid products. But apart from the sterile products that is injectable, and also one of the appropriate terms used for these two products which are injectable, that is parenteral products, and the packaging of these dosage form and the pharmaceutical industry, as well as the industrial hazards we have discussed in the previous semester course as well. The main objectives of this course is to focus on the various dosage form, and as you know that dosage form is the physical shape of the drug in which it is found. So we see that oral dosage form, topical dosage form, and parenteral dosage form, semi-solid dosage form, and the various types of the dosage form that I have already told you about, the emulsion, suspension, semi-solid dosage form, sterile products, and their packaging as well. Apart from the formulation of these dosage form, we will discuss, it is the main objectives of this course, it is equipment used for their formulation, and the course will have the following objectives. The first one is to learn about the formulation of pharmaceutical emulsion, suspension, and sterile products. In order to understand the various types of equipments used in the formulation of pharmaceutical emulsions, suspensions, and sterile products. The course also have aim to learn about the packaging, importance of packaging, and the various packaging lines, the ability to understand about the safety methods and various hazardous events in the pharmaceutical industries, including a fire, chemical, mechanical hazard, inflammable gases, and dust hazard as well. The learning outcomes after the completion of this course, all of you will be able to learn about the basic knowledge of the formulation regarding the different dosage form, like pharmaceutical emulsion, and equipment used for the formulation of pharmaceutical emulsion. Formulation of the pharmaceutical suspension. The equipment used in the formulation of pharmaceutical emulsion and various testing methods and equipment used for testing of pharmaceutical suspension, sterile products, the different areas classification and sterile area like class A area, class B area, class C area and class D area, and the various types of monitoring methods for the environmental monitoring and formulation of sterile products, the various types of excipient used in the sterile product formulation. These are also termed as added substances which are used in the formulation of pharmaceutical sterile products, and the testing and evaluation methods of sterile products like sterility test, pyrogen test, leakage test, which are mandatory tests for the evaluation of sterile products. Apart from these formulations, equipments and various testing methods of their evaluation or testing, you will be also able to learn about the industrial hazard, the main objectives of the industrial hazard, the different types and the prevention and safety methods regarding the hazards. Dear students, after the learning outcome, the course objective, the assessment and grading of this course will be comprised of the following distribution, that is the midterm exam paper, the 30% weightage will be given to midterm examination, and after the 8th week completion of courses, in the 9th week the exam will be conducted, and semester evaluation that comprises of assignments, and 4 assignments will be given to you people, and you should submit the relevant assignment on the portal within the specified time, and no submission will be entertained after due date, and 20% weightage will be given to these 4 assignments, and final term examination will comprise of 50% weightage of the whole course. Dear students, the course evaluation that we have conducted by using the university course evaluation system, and that is the week wise breakdown and detailed course plan, the week wise splitting of the contents of the course, and in the first week we will discuss these topics, that is regarding the discussion over the syllabus that we have discussed so far, and that is the week schedule, the timetable, the assignments and textbooks. And in this week we will also discuss the general lecture about the pharmaceutical emulsion. Apart from these, pharmaceutical emulsions and production, classification of pharmaceutical emulsion on various bases, like based on dispersed phase, based on the size of globules, and based on the route shape administration. Apart from this, formulation of pharmaceutical emulsion, and reference books as well. And the second week, we will discuss equipment used in the emulsification, comprising of the mechanical stirrer, homogenizer, and ultrasonifier. These are various types of equipment which are used for the formulation of emulsion or emulsification. In the second video, we will also discuss the stability of pharmaceutical emulsion, what is meant by stability and types of stability, including the physical stability and chemical stability, and various symptoms of physical stability like flocculation, creaming and sedimentation, phase inversion, coalescence, the causes and remedies of these symptoms, which are physical stability symptoms. We will also discuss the symptoms of chemical stability like oxidation and microbial growth, and different types of the antioxidants and antimicrobial agents in order to control the chemical instability and the pharmaceutical emulsion. In the third week, we will discuss the pharmaceutical suspension and the different subtopics, will be comprised of the general introduction regarding the pharmaceutical suspension, types of pharmaceutical suspension, formulation of pharmaceutical suspension, and equipment used for preparation of pharmaceutical suspension in detail, including the mechanical stirrer, homogenizer, colloidal mill, and ultrasonifier. In the fourth week, we will discuss the equipment used for test methods of pharmaceutical suspension, including the photomicroscopic technique, particle counter technique, cylindrical conduits, Bruckfold viscinator for the viscosity, for the specific cavity using the hygrometer, aging test, and introduction to semi-solid dosage form including ointments, paste, gels, jellies, apart from semi-solid dosage form introduction. We will also discuss in the fifth week the equipment used for ointments, paste, gels and jellies, and equipment used for patches, sprays, implants, sutures and plasters, sachet packing as well. In the same week, we will also discuss the sterile products and the various types of the areas classification, sterile and microbial air classification, and the various terminology used, including class 100 area, class 1000 area, class 10,000 and 100,000 areas, ophthalmic ointment definition, preparation and packaging, what is meant by complete sterility, aseptic processing, terminal sterilization, and air control including the laminar flow system, contamination control, the different types of contaminants including the personal bond contaminant control, and the various steps involved in the airborne contamination control, and introduction to environmental monitoring including the sources of contamination, personal training, major components of environmental monitoring, air control and microbiological air testing method, and how to control the surface monitoring and personal monitoring SOPs, introduction to sterilization process and the various types of sterilization according to United States Pharmacopoeia, including the steam sterilization, dry heat sterilization and sterilization by ionizing reaction. In the eighth week, we will also record the review of the topics covered up to 8th week, and after that, inshallah, the midterm examination will be held, comprising of 30% weightage. And after the midterm examination in the 10th week, we will discuss the filling, packaging, and process, quality control, test for the parenteral, and so on, packaging and packing, and safety method for pharmaceutical industries, and recommended books. These are also uploaded on the portal, like my favorite practice of industrial pharmacy, Cooper and Gund, and Remington Pharmaceutical Sciences, latest edition of these books. And the class will be held according to the timetable on the portal. The material will be uploaded prior to the online class. And you should consult the portal for PPT slides handout, which will be available on the portal, video lectures also be available, and free access will be provided to you on the portal, audio, video, or PPT, as well as online Google Meet session. And your grades depend upon the performance of the midterm evaluation 30%, final term evaluation 50%, and apart from these, the weightage of the assignments, that is 20%, and 4 assignments will be given to you people, and you should submit your assignment on the portal on time. WhatsApp group also for information sharing. And for online Google Meet session, we have planned to add your Gmail ID, and access will be given to the already provided IDs. So far we have scheduled in the previous semester. That's all about the weekly breakdown and the learning outcomes of this course. And the week wise schedule that I have told you earlier. Thank you all for your attention.